हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर शंकर दे। वेलकम टू सेकेंड सेशन ऑफ INICT 2021 नवंबर रिकॉल क्वेश्चन डिस्कशन। सो इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 टू 20। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 टू 10। सो गो थ्रू द फर्स्ट वीडियो देन कम टू दिस वीडियो। क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 वॉज अबाउट डेवलपमेंटल माइंडस्टोन्स। In the column A, there is series of events, and in the column B, there is timeline. So you have to match column A with column B. First option was transfer object. It is likely to occur during 5 to 6 months. Then walking 1 to 2 steps. This is during near about 1 year of age, like 12 to 13 months. Social smile 2 months. So 1 to 2 months. Pincer grabs, it's 9 to 11 months. So this is actually immature pincer grabs 9 months and mature 12. So likely the answer is for pincer grabs it is 9 to 11 months. So this is the matching developmental milestone column A with column B. Next, question number 12. Oil red O stain used in during which preparation? During histopathological examination in frozen section biopsy. So the answer will be frozen section. So oil red O is used in frozen section biopsy for demonstration of lipid. So oil red O. Question number 23. It was a big question, clinical questions. A boy presented with bilateral cervical lymphadenopathy, and on biopsy of lymph node, this image is found. So what is the diagnosis? What is the cell that is marked, and which virus is associated with this condition? As you can easily see, this is nothing but RS cell, Reed-Sternberg cell. So the diagnosis in this case, the first point is Hodgkin lymphoma. So this is a case of classical case of Hodgkin lymphoma. The cell marked is RS cell or Reed-Sternberg cell. Virus associated is Epstein-Barr virus, EBV. So this is a complete answer for today's question. Three segment or three part questions. Next. Question number 14, a child presented with chloroma and bilateral proptosis. Next investigation. For this question, the answer will be peripheral smear. So chloroma is nothing but extramedullary blast cells. So chloroma is usually seen in AML, acute myeloblastic leukemia, most commonly in M2 variety. So to diagnose AML, you will perform peripheral smear as next investigations. Next, question number 15. This was a very big question. The question was like a industrial worker, it presented to your hospital with some complaints of cough. Then on examinations, pleural thickening was found along with something carcinoma. And on biopsy, biopsy image was given. So these clinical features occurs due to industrial exposure of which substance? So the main clue was this image. So as you can see, this is nothing but image of one bodies, that is asbestos bodies, or also popularly known as ferruginous body. So asbestos body or ferruginous body, commonly seen because of long-term exposure of asbestos. So the answer is asbestos here. Okay, coming to question number 16. If mortality reduced by a drug, so one drug reduces mortality reducing drug, but did not cure the disease, So true statement for this drug. So effect of drug. the drug which reduces mortality but which do not have any therapeutic cure. So what will be the true statement for this drug? After using the drug, whether the prevalence increases or prevalence decreases, or prevalence incidence increases or incidence decreases, as the drug reduces mortality, so there will be accumulation of old cases. The number of new cases or incidence will be same, as is not related with new cases, but after new cases, as it reduces mortality, so it will definitely cause accumulation of old cases. So total number of cases will increase, or in other words, prevalence, old plus new case will increase. So in this case, the answer will be prevalence increases. Next, coming to question number 17, most common ocular manifestation in COVID-19. So COVID-19 coronavirus also affects our ocular system. The most common among these four options will be follicular conjunctivitis. So follicular conjunctivitis or COVID-19 eye, also known as pink eye. Conjunctivitis is the most common presentation among conjunctivitis. Follicular conjunctivitis is most commonly seen in COVID-19. Other options are like pseudomembrane conjunctivitis, retinal vein occlusions, keratouveitis. Next, question number 19. This image was given and the question was direct. What is the diagnosis? So this is very easy question. As you can see, the deposition of iris pigment over anterior lens capsule. So this is nothing but iris pigment deposition over anterior lens capsule because of blunt trauma or concussion injury. So this is nothing but vosseous ring. Next, coming to the question number 19, according to WHO classification, clear cell carcinoma in ovary is a type under which category? The options are like granulosa cell type, granulosa cell tumor, or sex cord stromal tumor, or epithelial cell tumor, or mixed like that. So clear cell carcinoma is nothing but variety of epithelial cell tumor. So epithelial variety of ovarian carcinoma, ovarian tumor, is clear cell carcinoma. Next, coming to question number 20, long question, column matching column A and B about nothing but ovarian markers. So almost all the important ovarian tumors and their markers are given in today's exam. For dysgerminoma, the marker is nothing but LDH. So for dysgerminoma, it is LDH. For epithelial cell tumor, it is CA125, cancer antigen 125. For granulosa cell tumor, it is inhibin. For choriocarcinoma, it is beta HCG for choriocarcinoma. And for Yorksack tumor, it is AFP. AFP for Yorksack tumor. So this is all about 11 to 20 number question. In the next video, I am going to discuss question number 21 to 30. Till then, subscribe the channel Dr. Shankar De and share the video with your friends, juniors and seniors. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.